Welcome to the video, guys. Today is Friday, the 14th of April. I woke up 187 pounds. So it's come back down from 189, and things are looking good because I've had a really good week. And today I'll be sharing my day of eating with you, which I promised in the last video, because a lot of you guys have been asking me what I eat day to day. So today I'm going to show you every single meal through from my breakfast right to the meal that I have before I go to bed. And it's actually quite a good time that I'm showing you this because I haven't really had structure for a long time. I've been doing a very flexible approach to my eating, and so I wouldn't have a typical day. But what I've been following for the past 5 days, and I intend to follow throughout my prep with this adjustments to calories, is the food that you're going to see today, because it's really helping me stay focused and not deviate away from my plan and not end up hitting my macros, which is what the ultimate goal of your day is to hit your calorie and macro targets, given that you have a good range of whole food quality nutrition. And yeah, you can fit in a few extra bits, but I'm trying to keep my food fairly clean right now because I feel really good on it, and yeah, I want to function well, feel good, perform well, and recover well. So here we go, kicking off today with like a breakfast shake, and this is how it looks. 250 mils of unsweetened almond milk. I have this because it's a real low calorie version of almond milk. There's no added sugar in it like the other one, so unsweetened is the one you want. I'll blend that with Weetabix. Now Weetabix is a complex carb source. It's a bit like oats but low in fat. It's virtually like zero fat in it, so it's real great to have to kind of keep your fats intake low. I'll then mix in some whey protein isolate. I'm going to be having pineapple, and the reason being is because I'm mixing in a fruit and greens blend. So this is like basically full of goodness. There's tons of micronutrients, phytonutrients in this one serving. So mixing that in with the whey protein isolate, any brand. I normally get my protein from bodybuilding.com because obviously I'm sponsored with them, and I like to pick and choose and mix things up. But I'm going with the whey isolate from USN. Then I also add in about 15 mils of apple cider vinegar. Now there's a lot of studies that have shown this to help with fat burning, so I'm going to mix that all in. And I've also got some frozen raspberries, which I haven't grabbed. But yeah, blend that all up and then whack that down. That is meal one. I was going to show you guys the frozen raspberries, but it looks like half of them have ended up on the floor. So we're probably going to have about 30 grams of raspberries today, but there you go. We're going to chuck some of those in there. I'm showing you guys what I'm eating. I also want to show you the supplements that I'm taking throughout the day at the different times. So this morning, first thing in the morning with my breakfast shake, these are the supplements I have pre-workout slash first thing in the morning. So I've got the Super Cortisol Support. It's just basically a mixture of natural herbal ingredients like green tea, ashwagandha, that help with energy, and a few of the basic kind of minerals and vitamins. One of those. I'm having this Strength Surge at the moment from EQ Nutrition. It's a testosterone boost supplement that boosts testosterone naturally with the core ingredient D-aspartic acid and zinc. So D-aspartic acid is pretty much known for the studies that have shown to increase free testosterone levels in the body. Having that. Ginkgo biloba helps with concentration for me. It really does help with blood circulation to extremities, so the arms, the legs, and the head. And so yeah, I have one of those first thing in the morning, and then I have acetyl L-carnitine, which I find really helps with fat burning. So you know, I'm in this calorie deficit now, getting ready for my show, and so having acetyl L-carnitine I find is real beneficial. So I have four of those in the morning. So that's it. It's my morning sups, and then I have some other sups later on in the day. You guys saw my pre-workout routine last time, but just in case you missed my last video, the video before, this is what I have before I work out. So I have pre-gym, one scoop of that bad boy, and then I also add in the creatine grenade engage. That's my pre-workout. Sit that down, and it's time to head to the gym. All right, so I just got to the gym, pre-workout as well, and truly kicked in. So I'm not going to shoot any of today's workout because I want to keep this video strictly to my day of eating and supplements because it's going to be quite a long one. During workout, this is what I'll be sipping on. This is Extend BCAAs. Normally have one scoop of that, which is around 10 grams. It helps prevent catabolism, so muscle breakdown. And yeah, it helps kind of
make your water taste better as well. So that's what I'm having intra workout. Gonna go and hit a chest and shoulder workout right now. Get that pump on and I'll come back and I'll show you guys what I have post workout, and then again for the rest of the day. Catch you in a minute.
Chest pump is rather real today. Time for post-workout recovery. Today, this is what we got.
Carbon by Lane Norton. Creatine Engage. One scoop of that. Get it from bodybuilding.com. Grenade Engage, also available on bodybuilding.com.
Guys, just a quick thing about post-workout nutrition. Now, I get a lot of questions around creatine and, you know, when to have it, when, why you should have it, who can have it, who can't have it. And a lot of studies have shown that creatine is one of the most beneficial supplements for improving your strength output and ATP recovery. So what that means is it's going to help give you more strength during short, high-intensity training. So if you're doing a bench press, you're going for low reps, or you're trying to do something explosive, creatine can actually help with giving you more power. So that's why I'm supplementing with creatine. Now, this is a different type of creatine. I would normally take creatine monohydrate and cycle and just have 5 grams daily. But this is like a different creatine blend, rather. And I don't know, I find that it's been really beneficial for me whenever I've gone into a cutting phase, because it helps me keep my strength quite high, and I also find that it helps improve my recovery. So this particular creatine brand has been really beneficial for me. Now, general creatine monohydrate, it's a lot cheaper usually. That's one of the cheapest supplements you can get that is actually proven to give you good sustainable results. And yeah, you could take that year round. You don't have to cycle it on and off, you don't have to load it, just have 5 grams daily and you're good to go. So I also have carbon post-workout for recovery. Now, it's got some key ingredients here which help improve your recovery and hydration. It's got 8 grams of BCAAs in the perfect ratio, which helps support muscle protein synthesis, which helps with your recovery. It's also got cherry pure in this, which is basically a recovery antioxidant ingredient, which has actually been proven in a lot of studies to help enhance your recovery. So I take this post-workout immediately after training, and then I go home and I get in some proper food, some nutrition, which is, well, food. Again, I have another shake, fast-acting protein, whey protein isolate, some form of like simple carb and some form of complex carb, just to keep me going until my next meal, which I'm gonna show you in a bit. But yeah, hope that makes sense. Post-workout recovery, amino acids, creatine, down the hatch, get it down, go home, get your nutritious shake in.
All right, back in the kitchen, and not much changes for my post-workout shake today, and pretty much every time I train, this is what I'm sticking with right now. So the only difference is, which you'll see here, is the hydrolyzed whey isolate from Dymatize. And the reason I have this is pretty much just to mix up the flavors. This is birthday cake flavor, it's pretty tasty. And it's hydrolyzed whey isolate, which is basically virtually zero fat, zero carbs, there's pure protein in there. 25 grams of protein per serving. 1 to 2 Weetabix. Today I've only had one because I've only had one left, but normally I'd have mixed in 2 Weetabix just for some complex carbs. 1 banana, which is around 60 grams, with, again, unsweetened almond milk, just for that flavor and that texture, and then some ice. So that's my post-workout shake. I'll have this now, which is within 25 minutes after training, just to kind of replenish glycogen levels, kickstart muscle protein synthesis, and then later on in about an hour, I'll have some food, which I'll show what I have, and keep this going.
birthday flavor.
Mmm.
When you're mixing a banana with your shake, it gives it this nice thickness. Give that one a try, guys. Mixing a banana with your shake, obviously account for the calories, but man, that's so much nicer than just having protein powder and water.
Back home, just had the head shaved off and shaped up. Well, from the side. It's time for lunch. It's quite late actually, it's 2 p.m. in the afternoon. Very late lunch for me. I'd normally eat around noon, but today I had a little lay-in because nobody wanted to train this morning except me. So we're gonna have some lunch now. Now, as you guys may already know, I'm sponsored by Yolo Food Company, and I actually would have Yolo Food regardless of my sponsorship because of the convenience of not having to prepare most of my meals in the day. I'm very busy, and food prep for me is just one of the last things on my priority list right now. But as I'm in prep mode, it means I need to be even more on point with my food and not slip up. And so I stick with the pure and simple range from Yolo Food Company, which is simple nutritious meals. Today I'm gonna go with the steak burger, which is lean beef mince, kind of put made with like some nice flavors. We've got some green veg here, and then they're really tasty white tomato. This is actually partially frozen still. So we're gonna stick this in the microwave for 9.5 minutes. 9.5 minutes. And this is gonna be my post-workout meal today, which is about an hour, 15, hour and a half after the last shake that you saw me have. So I'm gonna get this in the microwave, and this is my lunch. While my YOLO meal is cooking up in the microwave, I just wanna talk about the kind of food prep companies and how it's been really beneficial for people who are on a prep or trying to get leaner. Now, one of the biggest challenges with dieting is time, right? Food prep, spending that time cooking your food. So if you are struggling with cooking your meals and you don't have that extra hour, 2 hours, you know, 2-3 days a week to do, get yourself food delivered to you. Honestly, it's been one of the most helpful things over the past 18 months having these meals delivered to me, because they fill in the gaps in the day where I don't have time to prepare food. It's usually lunch and occasional dinners. I think today it's gonna be another YOLO meal, but I'm gonna show you guys what I have in between lunch and dinner as well, because you know, it's not just about having food prep for you. There is times in the day where I like to mix things up and have what I wanna have. So I'll show you guys what I have. But it's a massive convenience. If you don't have time because you're very busy working and you have, you know, a lot of duties that you need to fulfill in your day, honestly, get your food prepared for you, and it just makes life a lot easier. Now, the meals that I have from YOLO are already macro tailored, so I'm not giving them my macros. These meals are what they are, so I'll factor the meal into my day, and I'll pop the macros on the screen so you guys can see what's in that meal right there, and how that looks in my overall day. So it kind of fills gaps in the day and makes up my overall calorie intake. But again, massive convenience, easy to slot into a day, 9.5 minutes. And it's real tasty, really nutritious, and it just gets the job done. You know, when you're trying to get leaner, you don't really want to have to think too much about all the other aspects of nutrition. So yeah, life made easy. And if you guys want to benefit from YOLO and get a discount for my sponsorship, you can use the LC10, which will give you 10% off. Try them out for a week if you're based in the UK. See what you think of the meals. You know, I myself have been using them for about 18 months, and I find them very beneficial for my lifestyle and my nutrition needs even. So yeah, that's my take on food prep and how you can make it a lot easier than cooking every time, every meal a day. So here it is, guys. And as you can see, I've topped it up with a bit of tomato ketchup. Yes, there are calories in tomato ketchup. As you can see, there's 3.5 grams per 15 gram serving, and I've got 30 grams there, so that's 7 grams of carbs in a liquid form, but you know what? It tastes good, so that's why I'm having it. Then I've also got some of this French cheese mustard. Again, just a bit of flavor for the beef. I just like a bit of mustard with my red meat. And you've got 3.9 grams per 100 grams this time, but I've only got 10 grams there, so it's very fractional amount of calories coming from the mustard. Boom, right there, and there you go. We've got lunch sorted. Less than 3 minutes later, my plate is empty. Actually, a tip I want to give you, when it comes to eating your meals, don't eat them quick. That's one piece of advice I'll give you. And the reason why is if you eat your food quick, you're gonna still feel hungry very soon after the meal. So something that I'm trying to get better at is eating slower and taking my time to enjoy the food, because when you eat slower, your stomach sends a signal to your brain that you're actually full. So you're not gonna feel hungry after the meal. I literally still feel hungry from eating that. Now, it might be because I trained this morning and because I was really hungry before I ate it, but just a little tip for you is to try and take your time when you eat. You will stay fuller for longer. And when it comes to eating, try to eat when you feel hungry. So, you know, people ask me, oh, when's the best time to eat? How many meals should I have a day? This will be dependent on your lifestyle and what works for you, right? So I eat about 3 meals a day and 2 shakes, right? If you're up from early until late, then you're going to have more meals. Simple as, you know, or you, because you're going to feel hungrier. But if you don't feel hungry, don't eat because you've been told you need to eat every 2 hours or every 3 hours on the dot. You eat when you're hungry and you try to balance out your meals. Have some protein, have some carbs, have some fats, and try to get some greens with every single meal that you eat if you can. Now, the reason why I recommend you eating fairly regularly throughout the day, so not necessarily every 5 or 6 hours, but more like between 3 to 4 hours, is because when your blood sugar levels drop low, that's when the cravings kick in, and that's when you want to reach for anything you can see that's basically sugar. And that's when you have the lowest capacity to make a decision that is right for your body. You're too busy trying to get something that's going to give you quick energy. And that's why people reach for chocolate bars, for full fat, full sugar, Red Bulls, and Coca-Colas, because it's giving them sugar, which is gonna give them instant energy. Whereas if you try to eat more frequently and keep your blood sugar level stable, you're not gonna crave all that processed simple sugars, which is obviously not what you wanna have throughout the day. So try to eat when you're hungry, try to eat as regularly as 3 to 5 hours, and try to take your time when you eat, because it will keep you fuller for longer. So that's lunch, meal three technically, but my first solid meal of the day. And again, my day's starting quite late today, so I'll show you guys what I have next and what follows after that. I actually forgot to mention, I usually have a piece of fruit after my meals. Today we're gonna go with an apple. After the apple, and usually after I train with my post-workout meal, I usually have my vitamins. So today and every day I stick with these. So now I want to say something about vitamins in just a second. So we've got an antioxidant, mineral complex, omega-3, calcium, proflavonol, and acidophilus. So I have these post-workout, you know, your body is quite efficient with absorbing nutrients after you train. So that's why I try to have these in the meal that follows my training. At the moment, I'm using these products because I'm on prep. These are from a brand called USANA. Now, they are quite expensive, but for me, it's like, this is important that I optimize my health during prep. And as I'm in a caloric deficit and I'm not going to be getting the quality of food anymore, I like to have the highest quality supplements that I can have in order to get me optimize my health. Now, I'm not sponsored with these guys. I'm not affiliate of them. I just know that the quality is good. So I stay with these during prep. Now, very different to when I'm in an off season, I'll normally stick with one of the high quality multivitamins, which is like an all-in-one, because I'm getting enough calories and enough nutrients for my food. That's the difference between prepping and not prepping, is the quality of my vitamins. And yeah, trying to stick with as much high quality foods and supplements as I can when I'm in prep, so I can optimize my health. And yeah, these are gonna go down in one hit. Let's do this. All right. Here we go. So yeah, vitamins down and on to the next meal. So I'm working from home today, guys. I'm usually out and about at my gym, at private studios, or in coffee shops. But today I've decided to work from home because it's little bit more of a chilled day, good Friday, everyone's kind of taking their time off. And I wouldn't usually, well, this week I've been really kind of clean, as I said, with my foods. And I've been trying to avoid anything processed, just purely because how it was making me feel and it was triggering me. So a lot of the sweet things I was having, like protein bars, were setting me off to want even more. And I'm kind of an all or nothing guy. If I have a little bit, I want a lot. So I've kind of cut out having the dark chocolate, even though it's a good fat source. And I've stuck to things like almonds. And instead of having protein bars, I've been having eggs and rice cakes. But today I've decided to show you that you can actually have things that aren't on your typical diet plan and it won't affect your results. So I'm having right now a little snack. This is mid-afternoon snack for me, which is looking like a black coffee with some stevia. So I use this brand of natural sweetener called Truvia. I recommend it to all my clients because it tastes just like sugar, but there's no calories and there's no sugar. It's from a plant. Really good to add to coffee for a bit of sweetness. Okay, so there's also cashew nut milk in there. So let me quickly just show you guys cashew nut milk. Now, it's the first time I've ever tried it, but it's a new brand called from Alpro. And it's got a little bit of sugar in it, but it tastes pretty nice. And putting it in coffee just gives it that little bit of flavor. And yeah, so I'm having that. Then I'm having this bad boy. Now these are dangerous for me. So portion control is very important. So one dark chocolate mint carb killer. To be honest, all the carb killers are nice. My favorite is the peanut butter, but I haven't got any. Probably for the best. One of those, and then 150 grams of raspberries. So this is just like a snack. Got a little snack here. And that's gonna keep me going. I'm just working on some client plans right now. And yeah, this is gonna keep me going until I have my next proper meal. I call this kind of a snack because it's not really gonna hold me for longer than 2 hours, but it keep me going, keep me energized, keep me focused, and keep me from reaching for the carb cupboard. Cool, see you in a bit. Alright guys, it's evening now. Time is 10 past 6 in the PM. And this is classed as meal 5, if we're counting the shakes and the snacks. This is meal 5, and we're back to a proper whole food meal because I need to keep sustaining because I'm going out. It's Friday night, I'm going out. And this is where it's actually quite good that I've done the day of eating, because what I want to explain is whenever you're going out, especially if you've got a long day ahead of you, or you know you're not going to be going to bed till late, you want to save your calories throughout the day. So try and spread your meals further through the day. So eating every 3 to 4 hours, maybe 3 to 5 hours, and try to keep your meals a bit lighter during the day. So you can save some calories for when you get home, because you don't want to be getting home and having 0 calories left, or especially not having any protein. So try and save some protein, try and save some calories for the night, because I'm gonna get back around 1 a.m. and I wanna make sure that I've got food ready to eat. So dinner time for me looks like this. Okay, so what we got here? Coconut oil. So we're gonna use this to cook and heat up the vegetables. So I like to go for the organic coconut oil, just because. Going to be frying up some mixed vegetables, so half a pack of mixed vegetables. I'm actually going to cook all of the vegetables because I'm going to have it tomorrow for lunch. So I've got half a pack of mixed vegetables. Mix in with some spinach, so a couple handfuls of spinach. Lots of iron in there, lots of zinc, really good for your vitamin and minerals. And then we've got boodles. Now these are butternut squash noodles. Super low in carbs, great for dieting, and as you can see, the macros are 8.7 grams of carbs per half pack. So you're getting a lot of volume for not a lot of calories, and you're looking at 50 calories. So pretty good on the macros there. Mixing in with half a pack of Tilda Mexican bean and chili. Macros, we're looking at half a pack, 125 grams, which is 25.6 grams of carbs, 158 calories. So that's gonna make up the more complexy carbs. And then I've also got here a chicken breast, which I made the other day. So it's just a chicken breast from Marks and Spencer's. Got a bit of herbs and seasoning on it, and then there's also a little bit of oils, which is gonna add to the fats. And then a couple top-ups with Cholula hot sauce. This is my favorite sauce. It's zero calories. It's basically water, but with some spices. And I'm gonna mix in some chili garlic and the original. And then we're gonna use some pink Himalayan sea salt to top it all off. There we go, all of that. Whack it all in there. And then there we have meal five. I'm gonna also top this with some cayenne pepper. All right. There we have, nice low calorie, quick and easy dinner. I'll also give you guys the macros on the screen so you can see exactly what's in this in terms of protein, carbs and fats and total calories. And as you can see, it's a lot of food for not a lot of calories. That meal had a kick from the cayenne pepper. But, you know, it's all good for the extra thermogenics. And speaking of thermogenics, as I said, I always have a piece of fruit. Well, I try to have a piece of fruit with every meal. And this meal, I'm having half a grapefruit, which is around 13 grams of carbs. But there's tons of fiber in grapefruit and vitamin C. And there's actually been a lot of research and studies that have found grapefruit to help with fat burning. I don't know if it's a direct correlation of eating grapefruit, but there were some studies to show that the pectin within grapefruit, which is an ingredient inside the fruit, it helps with fat burning. But I like to have it because it actually also helps shut off any cravings for any sweetness after a meal. So after I have half a grapefruit, I'm normally pretty done. And then lots of water, and then I'm out. So I won't eat my next meal for another 5, maybe 6 hours. So that meal's got to keep me going, be drinking lots of water. Might have some sort of like sugar-free caffeinated drink. And yeah, that's it. Gonna keep going and then check in with you guys with my last meal before I go to bed. Meal number 6. See you later. I love the end of the day, guys. So I've just got back pretty tired and just took a look at what I had scheduled for tonight. And it turns out that I can have a little bit more than what I thought I could have. So with what I've scheduled in, it takes me to 250 calories, and I've got another 200 calories to put in. So what I'm going to do right now is sit here for a few minutes and put in some extra foods. It's going to be the basics, but I'm just going to put it all in and come up with a meal that satisfies my calories and fills me up before bed. I like to go to sleep with quite a full stomach because, especially with carbs, I find it really helps my sleep quality. So if you're struggling with sleep, try having some carbs before bed. And so complex carbs, the ones I'm talking about. So porridge oats, Weetabix, anything substantial. All right, we're getting there. So this is me on my fitness pal, just doing the math. So I've really under-eaten today. Not deliberately, but it just happens that I've been really busy today and my day started a lot later than usual. Normally I start my day at 5:30 in the morning. And so by this point, like I've literally just got like 300 calories left for my last meal. But so far it's looking at about 600 calories. This last meal is looking like 4 Weetabix, 120 grams of banana, 50 grams of the GF1 protein, 300 mils of almond milk, let's make that 4, and then 20 grams of raisins. That is going to be a hefty bowl. And what I'm actually going to do, so my day is going to end on 271 carbs, 226 protein, and 41 fat. Now my targets are 280 carbs, so that's 9 grams under, 230 protein, so 4 grams under, and 50 grams of fat, so 9 grams under. Now I've got quite a lot of social things going on this weekend, and I could just eat all of the calories now just because I can, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to save some of my fat allocation for tomorrow or Sunday, because I know I'm going to have more opportunities to get in more fat. So instead of having 50 grams tomorrow, I'm going to have 60 grams tomorrow, or 59 grams tomorrow rather, if that makes sense. So that's what you can also do with your calories. If you got to the end of the day and you really don't need to eat anymore, you're full up, don't stuff yourself just because you've got a target to hit. Eat what you need to feel satisfied, and then you can save the rest of the calories for the next day or later in the week. But just try to not push it over too many days, because you'll forget what you've had and you end up over consuming. So just try to have it within the next day or two at most. So yeah, it's looking like a nice big bowl of porridge, and this is gonna make me sleep like a baby. So this is what we got, guys. It looks very similar to my breakfast shake and my post-workout shake, but the difference is what you're going to see in just a moment. So we've got the unsweetened almond milk, banana. I'll probably have to have 1.5 because that will be around 100 grams. 4 Weetabix tonight, which is going to be so tasty. And then we've got this Timely's protein from USN, which is chocolate peanut flavor, and I love anything peanut buttery. So that is all going to go into the blender. Okay, guys, so what we've got right here is a thick, extremely thick paste of Weetabix. 4 of those with protein. Now this is going to be extremely thick. It might not even come out. Wow. It is like solid. And I didn't plan this. Oh, look, it's coming. Here we go. So I'm going to have to get a spoon to this, I think. This is going to definitely be a spoon job. So I normally make this with either 2 or 3 Weetabix. I don't think I've ever done it with 4. But damn, this is going to be so good. I think this is my favourite meal of the day, if I've got any calories left. Alright, that's for after. Never ever waste a single gram. When you're dieting, every single gram counts, so you can guarantee that ain't gonna get wasted. So next up, get it in the microwave, man. That's what we're gonna do. Got a bit of a snivel today. So I'm gonna put that in there for 2 minutes, and then I'm gonna chuck in 20 grams of raisins, give it another stir, and then we're gonna hit it for another minute or so, and you're gonna see this thick, thick paste. Oh yeah. Look at that beauty. Has to be my favorite meal of the day. All right, guys, that is my final meal of the day. I really want to eat it, so I'll keep this brief. I hope you guys enjoyed my full day of eating video. I've never done one of these before, so I really appreciate your feedback. Leave a comment below and let me know what you thought of the video and if you found it helpful. I've given you guys all the macros of every meal, and I'll also show you my total daily intake. So this is exactly what I'm eating right now. In order to strip body fat, and that's something I really want you guys to understand, that today's day of eating
is me eating in a caloric deficit, which is in order to burn body fat, because right now I'm trying to get lean for a competition. So my day of eating will vary when I'm in an off season to how I'm eating now, but I wanted you guys to see how I eat to try and stay within my caloric needs on a deficit, which is a lot harder than when you're in a surplus. So I hope you enjoyed it. Please like this video if you did enjoy it, and of course subscribe to my channel and follow my journey, because I'm gonna spend a lot more time here on YouTube, as I said. So subscribe for more videos from this channel and on my prep. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace. That's the one.